Iain Gardner, a guest on the First Dates dating program, sat down with Mark Walker to discuss his experience and the current dating scene.
So welcome to Latest News. I'm here with Iain Gardner, and we're going to be going behind the scenes with First Dates. You were on the First Dates program, which is a Channel 4 dating program for those that don't know.
Correct.
You were on it in May, so what was your experience?
The experience was a positive experience. It was going back to a traditional way of dating people.
Yes.
Rather than using apps, which I think have killed the dating scene these days. So going back to a blind date set up by your friends was a great experience. It was quite a natural process. Nothing was staged per se. And I think the experience itself was quite good.
Yeah. How does one get on the programme? Do you just apply
I apply through their website on their TV channel, applied through the website. You go through quite a rigorous process. They do ask quite in-depth questions about your sexuality, about your sexual preferences, so they can try and get a good match with the person they're going to set you up with. As far as my match was concerned, I would say they got about 85% correct. The 25% that wasn't quite right, I needed a little bit more of, and there wasn't enough of that 25% to make it a sort of ongoing date. However, it did go to a second date.
Okay, and so when you're in that restaurant, you know who's going to be arriving there. You've seen a profile of them?
No, nothing. Absolutely nothing. It's right. Completely blind date. The minute you walk through the door is the first time you actually see or get a glimpse of the person you might be on a date with.
I think that could be the reason why it's quite an effective program, because it looks very natural, doesn't it?
It is.
To the viewer, at least, anyway. So it was well put together then. What can we learn about that way of dating? Because, as you say, it is a return to a more traditional way.
I mean, it was uncontrived. It was not set up. There was no preconceived ideas. It was just going to be a blind date. And again, in that respect, because someone's actually saw the two characters, the two people, and brought them together, might be a way in which it worked better than meeting someone just in a bar that you don't know their characteristic traits, where someone else has set it up for you, similar to like a friend would back in the 80s and 90s.
Yeah.
So overall, it was quite a positive experience.
And anything in particular for the gay dating scene that you think people can learn from?
Put your mobile phones down. Put your mobile in your pocket. Yeah. When you go into a bar, engage with people that are at the bar. I can go into many bars within Brighton, and as soon as you walk through the door, people have actually got their heads down in their phone and they haven't even realised you've walked through the door.
Yeah.
And they remain that way until such times you leave. So nobody's got any engagement skills, because I think the apps have sort of destroyed that slightly.
Yes, yeah.
So going back to a blind date, or going out dating on the scene, or going out to a restaurant and meeting people, I think is a better platform these days.
Yeah. And why do you think people keep on watching First Dates? Because we're kind of on... There's been at least 8 series, I think, of... 12 series,
yeah. I was on the 12th series.
Yeah.
I think because it's quite natural, it's not set up in any way. You're not bringing oil and water together. You're actually bringing two people who are looking for, shall we say, romance, bromance, or they're looking for a date in a sort of traditional setting. And there's no better way to do that than to actually sit around a dinner table, have good food, good wine, good conversation.
Good conversation, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
the guy was, my date was same ilk as myself, school of hard knocks,
had
lived life. So there was a lot of things in common. And it did go to a second date, which came to Brighton.
It did come to, and that was a shot in Brighton, was it, as
it
well?
It was, yeah. Some of the footage was taken in Brighton, and then obviously put at the end of the show.
Yeah.
That was quite an experience as well, because it brought him back into the gay sort of scene.
Yes.
He's from the Isle of Wight, and there's very little gay scene except for that once a year Pride.
Yeah.
So it opened up his eyes, and he thoroughly enjoyed it.
And before we go, you can go on it again, because I know people have had dated more than one person. So is that something you're planning to do?
I was thinking First Dates Hotel.
Okay.
I think it's just started the current
series. That's good fun as well, actually.
Yeah. So I wouldn't mind giving that a go if that was an option.